My name is Izabella. I'm from Vancouver, Washington.
And who is this gentleman?
This is my amazing husband, Roman.
Awesome. Thank you guys for coming. Now, what was the thing that you struggled with in your life? Can you please share?
Yes. So it kind of started when... So I went to visit my family last year, and I kind of started getting like self-doubts, negative thoughts, how like I'm not good enough, how like I'm a nobody. And I don't know why, like I disregarded seeing the stuff that I'm good at. I just started believing the stuff that I'm bad at. And it started slowly by that, and then slowly like worse thoughts came, how like maybe there's no God, or like even like suicidal thoughts. And it came to a point like life just got so hard, I had to quit my job. I couldn't focus at all. Like even doing laundry just seemed like a big mountain to climb over because the thoughts just kept bombarding me. And at times it was like the worst, where I even like attempted suicide, and my like husband thankfully was right by me and like saved me.
So those kind of like intrusive thoughts, you accepted them and they turned into the severe depression that you were struggling, right? How long, what's the period of time when you were struggling with that?
Till I fully got free was about 7 months, when I was like just laying in bed, and like I would watch a lot of sermons and still like the devil's like, there's no God, you're like hopeless. And I also became very like isolated. I'm like, everybody hates me, like I just want to like even hide in my own house. It was really bad. But thanks to God, yeah, here I am.
So before we go... So could you please share, how did it affect your daily life and your relationship with your husband? And when were you in search of solution for that?
How it affected our marriage. We kind of had no marriage. Like, I don't know, life was just, it was just going in circles, the same thing every day. Like, I'd wake up, I'd hope like, okay, new day, I'm going to start fresh. And it was just the same, like from the time I would wake up to the nighttime, like just bad thoughts. And people couldn't really understand, like some people like, just be happy, you know, you have a good husband, you have a good job, you have a good house. And they didn't understand like it was much more deeper than that. And my mistake was that I was not experienced in this, and I started like accepting these thoughts. And if I, like my dad said, you can't stop a bird from flying above your head, but you can stop from it laying a nest. And like, I didn't realize how these thoughts, they can start out being really small, and eventually like they can just overtake your life.
Share a little bit, how did that affect your job, that, you know, you even had to quit your job because of that?
Yeah, basically I even started asking our clients to pray for me. It, you know, was getting kind of out of hand. I couldn't focus, like my, since I had so many thoughts, like I kind of kept like slurring my words, like things kind of didn't start making sense. I just didn't know what to do. And I reached out. At first, I didn't want to tell anybody about my husband. I'm like, this is so embarrassing. And then people kind of started noticing like I wasn't happy and just stuff. And then I reached out to my family, and I would even have to come over. Like my husband worked part-time. He had to always be by me. Like if he wasn't, I would have to go to my mom-in-law's because I didn't feel safe by myself. And then I reached out to my relatives, and like my aunt, like it's just like, let's go to, I went to a few conferences. I even came to here for the deliverance prayer, and like I was afraid to go up on stage, and like people are gonna like hate me or just think I'm weird. And she like grabbed my wrist, she's like, let's go, like, you know, this isn't something to be afraid of, like the devil just wants to keep you safe, like isolated. And yeah.
And so how long ago was it when you came here for the prayer? We have these monthly prayer lines. We pray for deliverance. And for those who don't know, and she was one of them that she came, and she was so afraid. Like she said, when she was talking to me on the back over there, she thought I was hating her, like those intrusive thoughts. And she was so fearful to be prayed for. But thank God for her husband and her aunt that actually, you know, kind of came alongside and kind of pushed her to be in the prayer line. And what was your experience during the prayer line, and how did you receive your freedom?
Yeah, so I came up here to pray, and my freedom, it didn't like snap, you know, right away. It was like a slow, big process. So first I started making myself socialize with people, and I started really searching for God, because the devil, like I even told my husband, I'm like, is there a God? Like, why would God allow this to happen for, you know, to me? And I started really searching and praying, like fasting. My husband would encourage me, and even my aunt, like all the stuff that I would say about myself, I'm like, hate myself, I'm a nobody. She like took those words, wrote them down, and then she's like, we're gonna reject these right now and like break them. And then she made me start saying even just simple stuff, like, I'm thankful I have arms, just kind of stuff to, like, get me back on my feet. And it's been about, 7 months since the whole process. And when I kind of, like, I basically had a thought to go to a naturopath, because back in the day, I went to my doctor and he's like, you're depressed, here's some antidepressants, we're not going to take your blood. Like, he just wanted kind of to put me on pills. And I went to her and I had low vitamin D. And I believe when you're physically weak, that's when the devil starts attacking you spiritually. So it was, like, tied in. And I was, like I said, I became suicidal. I'm like, I can't live like this. What is this life? And my husband, like, did not give up on me. He was by my side. We prayed, and slowly, like, now I'm free. Everything's, life is beautiful. Like, it was from, like, black and white to, like, life in color. I just love people so much, want to help everyone, and Jesus is amazing.
Come on, guys, put your hands together for God. Wow, this is so amazing. We're just so happy for you to see this black and white difference of what God can do in person's life, you know, to deliver a person from depression, intrusive thoughts, and suicidal tendencies. We're just so happy for you. Thanks for sharing. So now we want to hear a little bit from your husband, Roman. Come over here. Come on, guys, if you clap, let's clap. So, Roman, how did this issue affected you personally and your marriage, and how were you able to go through this with her? Can you please share a little bit?
Yeah, it was, like she said, very difficult, because I actually didn't know, like, what each day would bring. So, like, when it got really bad to where I couldn't leave her by herself, like, she would just, like, I would leave to work, and she's like, okay, I'll do some stuff, and then she texts me, like, oh my gosh, I can't do this, like, all these thoughts, I need to go somewhere. I'm like, okay, go to my mom's house, and so it was very difficult, and so I started searching for, like, you know, where is this attack coming from, because I know that, like, if you leave a door open somewhere for the devil, then, you know, he has the right to attack you, and so, yeah, it gave me kind of more kind of confidence in, like, searching, you know, and getting closer to God, and kind of searching where in our lives did something that we didn't do right. And so this kind of whole process and happened that I see now, looking back, that, you know, I never prayed for things like that involved something like this, where I could see my wife is struggling. I could see, like, the devil's attacking her, and she's saying, like, I need to die. Like, you know, I'm like, no, that's not you. That's the devil, you know? And I started looking online, and people sending me stuff, and her aunt sent me stuff, and as well as, you know, coming to the prayer here. And so to me, like, a lot of this stuff I was not aware of, even growing up as a Christian in a family, that there's a big spiritual world out there, and that it's real. And so it gave me more confidence. I prayed for her, and, like, I kind of took up that boldness to, like, rebuke these demons. It grew me spiritually a lot. And now I can kind of see other situations, and I'm like, I see that. That's the devil. Like, those are not those people. God created people in his image, and the devil just turned it around and tainted these people. And so throughout this journey, it really spiritually grew me and my wife, and we got closer to God, and we are a lot stronger than we were before.
Come on, you guys. Hallelujah. Thank God. Come over here again. Would you please share a word of advice to people who might be struggling with depression or suicidal tendencies or intrusive thoughts and just battling this spiritual darkness? What would you suggest to them?
Well, first, when you start getting negative thoughts, don't let them go further. Just talk to somebody as soon as possible, because it can overtake your life. Also, don't isolate yourself. That just causes more, like, depression, even though you feel like you might be better, but it's not. The enemy just wants you to be by yourself. And then third, like, don't limit God. Some people are like, oh, I feel like God won't do this, but God created everything in the world. He's powerful. And just keep praying, keep seeking God, and God will eventually come through.
Thank you guys so much for sharing.
Thank you for watching this content. I know this was a blessing to you. We would like to ask you to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell on our channel so that each time we upload something, you can be notified. Don't forget to share this content with your friends and family and on social media. We're so thankful to you. Better is not good enough. The best is yet to come.